Furniture.
No, 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 a mí, de ahí.
They total 89. Okay, we will go ahead and get started with Brad.
Yeah, Luke, Svefty, you made that last basket and you kind of walked off toward the timeout and put your arms in the air. What's kind of going through your mind at that point?
The fans. It's been a tough stretch, you know, not having fans. Now we have them back a couple, and you know, we just that's for them. I really appreciate everybody coming and hoping to have more soon.
All right, Tim McMahon.
Hey, Luca, where do you think you've made the biggest strides as a scorer over the last year?
I would just say be more aggressive, you know. Sometimes I'm not so aggressive. I take terrible shots, you know, those setbacks. Today was a couple of them too. Shot some bad shots, but, you know, sometimes they're going to go in, sometimes not. But I just got to be more aggressive and take better decisions.
Kevin?
Hey, Luca, obviously you've had some big moments against this basketball team in the past. What is it about the Clippers that seems to bring out the best of you when you get together with Paul George and Kawhi Leonard and these guys each time you play?
I mean, they're a really good defensive team, you know. They have really amazing defenders, so it's kind of tough. But, you know, I think these two last – I mean, past two games were like playoffs, you know, when you play hard, and that's how we got to be ready for the playoffs if we make it.
Tim Cato?
Hey, Luca, just overall the defensive performance from everybody involved, what did you make of that, and you know, who stood out, and what was your performance there, do you think?
I think everybody stood out, you know. Everybody played great defense. That's why they have 84 points, or how many? 89 points. I think that's great defense against a really great team. And, you know, everybody had a great defense today.
Okay, we're going to move to Spanish. We'll start with Pedro.
Thanks, René. Luca, buenas noches. Luca, ¿cuáles crees que son los ajustes que hizo el equipo el día de hoy a diferencia del partido del lunes para sacar el resultado? Y también hablabas de ese momento especial con los fanáticos. ¿Qué significa para ti hacer una jugada como esa y poder obviamente tener a los aficionados ahí?
¿Cuál era la primera pregunta? Perdón.
Perdón, eran los ajustes.
Ah, vale. Hemos jugado mucho más duro. Eso creo que fue todo. Jugar duro. Es un equipo... Es increíble que puedo ganar el anillo, así que lo que hemos hecho, el ajuste, es jugar más duro y más motivados. Y lo segundo, bueno, estoy muy feliz de poder tener aficionados. Es lo que es el deporte, ¿no? Sin aficionados no es lo mismo, es mucho peor, pero con aficionados es increíble.
And JC.
Enhorabuena, Luca. Has hecho 42 puntos. ¿Crees que puedes mantener este ritmo anotador, esta eficacia, y crees que la presencia de esos aficionados en la pista te ha motivado aún más para actuar como has actuado esta noche?
Bueno, sí, seguro, porque me recuerdo empezar la temporada sin aficionados, era un poco así, no vas a jugar tan motivado como si hay aficionados.
Okay, and then the last one is Leonardo.
Luca, ¿qué tal? Buenas noches, te saluda Leonardo Torres desde Perú. Dos consultas. La primera, ¿te vas contento con tu desempeño de esta noche? Y la segunda, ¿tenemos que acostumbrarnos a ver partidos de 40 puntos o más?